It is the newest music from the country where Handel composed the Messiah. This is punk rock, and its purpose, one observer says, is to promote violence, sex, and destruction in that order.
And now they're bringing out these freak punk rock groups.
Look at me! They're gonna put you away!
Make your desires reality.
Well, here's how it's
genocide.
Well, here's how it's
genocide.
Cares.
Yeah. Wow.
Six Nation cast chamber. Well, six Nation cast chamber. Orgasm. Well, this
starts. Starts.
Phases of
starts. Starts.
Recorded and documented.
Well, this next movie. Come on, yeah. Hey,
Fashion trend. Fashion coordinator, Jan Stefan.
Hello.
Hi, welcome to the Boogie Disco Palace.
Thank you.
Jan, what's new in Canada?
Punk rock, punk fashion to go along with it. Here we have Mary Jane.
Okay, come on out, Mary Jane.
Mary Jane's wearing a do-it-yourself outfit made from old clothes in our closet and bits of mesh, and safety pins, studs, paper clips, bolts, all kinds of just stuff out of your hardware closet.
Why do punk rock musicians wear safety pins? What's with safety pins?
The safety pin is very easy to make clothing out of. As you can see, we've shaped it with the safety pins. Also, it's beautiful. It's been made out of gold and silver. It's a beautiful piece of jewelry.
Who's next?
Raymond, the male counterpart. And he is definitely a punk.
What does punk mean?
Punk, as a fashion, is a rebellion of urban living and teenagers. He's wearing studs, ripped t-shirt to fit him, running shoes, chains. It's all very angry and rattly. It's like rattling of bars of prisoners.
And locks? What do the locks mean?
The locks are, again, rebellion. Again, frustration, anger.
And do they dance? Is there such a thing as punk dancing?
I think they're going to show you what it's about.
This is punk dancing, eh? I wonder if it'll ever go over big in the discos.
It's very sensitive, in fact.
You know, it's just his life is so intensely profound, you know, like the Sex Pistols are. They're just, their lyrics and everything about them is so deep, you can just really get into them.
Well, there you go, that guy who you reckon was primed actually happens to be a member of a band called the Angelic Upstarts. Now, they're a band who started off very similar to yourself, Johnny, in the Sex Pistols.
Yes, come on. I don't give two what they're called. It's simple. Don't tell me I sold out, pal.
I didn't tell you. That guy
was the only honest band in 2,000 million years. I could not help the management being corrupt. I don't want to talk about the past. I want to go on.
Well, all right. He also spoke about what you're doing now. And he reckons you've sold out. And
is this
like... He doesn't know what we're doing now. He doesn't seem to know anything.
Well, has he ever seen us?
Could you... I don't know. I didn't ask him that. Could you let us know what you're doing now, what you're into now, what your link with the street?
Look, I don't have to explain myself to anybody and I ain't gonna really bother. Now, I was asked here, right, to interview with the band here, Pill, but now, like, we're facing a cheapskate comedy interrogation act and it just ain't on, pal. It's a joke. It's a farce.
You mean you don't want to give any messages to...
I don't have to explain myself. Sooner or later, somebody will open their eyes. Oh, sorry, rude word.
Well, it sounds like we've heard this story before.
Really? Would you like to tell me where? Good night.
Good night.
Want to continue?
Well, that's up to you entirely. Do you all follow the leader?
No, go on. Yeah, you don't know leader.
Well, all right.
I thought that was the point of having four people. You asked just me and him, didn't you, to do
all right,
an
come on, the rest of the band.
Oh, why don't you try answering an intelligent question? Try and think of one.
Tell you
if
what.
You've never asked one in your life.
Let's forget about it all.
Right.
Yeah, I think you should.
No, that is total cop-out.
Cop-out!
I'm really into it, and I'm into the punk rock scene, and they moved me. They made me shake more than I've ever shook before, and that's what makes them the best.
Yeah, what are they singing?
What are they singing? Who cares what they're singing? They're singing, who cares? Who fucking cares? Get out of here.
What are they saying?
Who, it isn't what they sing. Get out of here.
Yeah, what are they saying? Let's sing.
Get out of here. Get out. Get. I don't want to mess any cameras up. I don't want any trouble. Get the fuck out of here.
Begrüßen Sie wirklich recht herzlich zu unserem heutigen Fernsehprogramm und wünschen Ihnen einen recht guten Empfang.
names?
Michelle Lacey.
John Bennett.
Nancy Telsner.
And do you work or unemployed or what?
I go to college, Huddersfield.
Unemployed.
Sorry?
Unemployed.
Huddersfield.
Right, now, I've asked the other people I've interviewed, could you tell me about your clothes, your style of dress, where you get the clothes from?
Mostly second-hand places and stuff, and mostly I make them myself.
Yeah, some of the others said they got them from Oxfam shops and jumble sales, that type of place. Is that right?
Yeah, it's the most original places there is for that sort of clothes.
Yeah, and is that the same with you?
Yeah, buy dresses and cut them up and just do anything with.
Well, so actually buy dresses and...
Second-hand dresses.
Yeah, okay. And your outfit's a bit unusual to say the least. Did you make it yourself?
Yeah, I made it off a sheet off a bed.
You made it out of a bed sheet?
Yeah.
Yeah,
that's
okay.
Where I get all those clothes from. My sheets.
And your hairstyles, do you do them yourself or do you get them specially done?
Well, I went to an hairdresser's and they didn't cut it how I liked it, so I just do it on my own way.
Well, so they didn't cut it how you wanted it to be cut, so you spiked it up like that?
Yeah.
And what about you?
I worked at that hairdresser's. I didn't do it, I got sacked the morning she came in for an hair doing.
It wasn't you that cut hair, was it?
Me. I would have done it, I'd have made a better job than what other woman did.
Yeah, okay, and what about you?
Supposed to be doing my hair, but it got sacked, so she did it and it was awful. I had to do it myself.
So you was working at the hairdresser's and you got sacked because someone cut her hair badly?
No? I got sacked the morning that these two were coming in for the hair doing. And I was going to do the hair, but she sacked me, so she did the hair with a mess of it.
So that's why you got a hair cut now, you didn't want it to be cut?
Yeah, it
did. Okay, now what sort of music do you like? Obviously you like this alternative style of music, but in particular, could you sort of make it a bit more specific?
Smiths mainly, and Echo and the Bunnymen, stuff like that. Out generally, just... No particular taste, just absolutely out. Just depends.
Well, I like Alien Sex Fiend and the Specimen and the Cramps, Birthday Party, Virgin Prunes, Oatreal Pumpkin.
Stranglers, Soft Cell, things like that.
Now, a couple of the others were saying they like Glenn Miller. What do you think? So the Glenn Miller, I know it's about 30 years out of date, but what do you actually think to it?
She drags me up to dance. I don't like it at all.
No, I don't like it. Don't agree with me at all. It's just terrible. It really is.
Okay, right. Thanks ever so much.
It just gives me, you know, a good feeling when I'm there. It says to me that I should do what I want to do, you know, and just fuck everybody else. Just fuck everybody else, you know, just fuck them.
It's only imagination. No one would sneak in.
Thank you.
wondered from time to time whether punk rock is really anything to do with music.
Well, I think it's obviously the music is the thing which brings all of the people together in the first place, and a lot of the music has, I think, fairly important political comments to make, and those comments may be naive, but I think we've tended to believe over the years that because political expression was naive, that there was somehow something wrong about it, in the same way that we tend to find management people more plausible than trade union people because they speak better. I think the naivety in the music really has got very little to do with the sincerity or accuracy of the statements that it's making politically.
Let's go! 15-22!